Welcome inside. I want to bring in our special guest for today. He really doesn't need much of an introduction in the state of Alabama. He's a Hall of Famer. He's a Super Bowl champion, a CIAA champion, a SWAC champ. He is Barbara Ann's boy, Rich Chris Reggie, the head coach of the DC Defenders of the XFL. And I got to ask you this, Coach. First of all, congratulations. You got your first win of your professional career as a head coach. What are some of the differences that you've noticed in being a pro head coach versus the college ranks?
I mean, obviously, the resources are totally different. The athletes, I mean, these guys are, they fit the pyramid. I mean, they're huge guys. Up front, offensive line guys are really big and move really well. Obviously, the terminology is a little different, and they catch on to it. They're professionals, and they understand that the preparation that they put in will ultimately affect their performance. So they're pros about it. And, it's, I don't have to check study hall. We don't have to do some of the check classes and stuff. So those are some of the differences. But, obviously we had a great time coaching college, really enjoyed it. But this is fun as well.
You know, you mentioned that you were now working for Dwayne "The Rock" Johnson. I'm sure that goes with a lot of responsibilities as well, because after all, there's a lot of resources that you have available to you at the pro level. What's that been like so far?
Yeah, it's been great. I mean, one of the attractive things about this job or this opportunity when we were approached about it is the leadership of the league, the ownership and the leadership. Ms. Danny Garcia, Mr. Jerry, and of course, Dwayne Johnson, being, you know, the owners of the league. And then of course the executives that they had that, Russ Brand, that's, in his position as executive of the league. Those guys have great NFL experience, know a lot of people. So it was the leadership and the ownership that really made it attractive. And then of course, being able to coach on a pro level, was really cool as well. But it's been cool. Obviously, we know Ms. Danny Garcia, Dwayne Johnson. I mean, they've been extremely successful in their career, as well as Mr. Jerry. And just wanted to be a part of it. Obviously, they're doing it the right way in terms of player safety, uniforms, just all of it. They've been doing it the right way. So just happy to be a part of it.
I want to ask you about mentorship. And of course, when you're mentoring the kids that are, when I say kids, I mean the collegiate athlete. Now these guys have matriculated into professional football, so they have different needs. They're taking care of families and things like that at this point. But I heard an interview a few weeks ago from one of your former teammates, Warren Sapp, and he said that Coach Dungy used to tell you guys there's like five things to avoid when you're out there, and I see the light bulb going off. And he mentioned, like, you know, if you're going over the speed limit, if you got a gun, if you're in a car with a woman that you know too well or don't know at all. And there's some other things that go along with that. Have you seen in your experience that is pretty much a magic formula for trouble? And how do you address that to these young men to keep them safe and to keep them out of trouble?
Yeah, obviously that's spot on what Warren Sapp said. That the information that Coach Dungy gave them, obviously, you know, he's a Hall of Fame coach, and he's so right. And we try to spill that over to our guys. And one of the things that I think help is you kind of have a little instant credibility when they know you've been through what they've gone through, training camp, being away from your family, practicing, those hours that goes with that, and being able to communicate, you know, the things that you need to do to maintain or sustain your career. We were able to speak on that because we had Obviously, we had those experiences ourselves. We actually have an event today for our guys in terms of mentorship, developing them today is financial literacy that Brian Westbrook, who's part of the XFL, will be presenting an opportunity for these guys to learn and talk about financial literacy, which is extremely important, right? We've seen all the stories of guys playing ball and then, of course, leaving ball and not having things work out so for them so well. So there's definitely a lot of things that we want to continue to do. That's the other part of being a head coach. You still get an opportunity to develop young men, and it's been pretty cool to do that.
Last question for you. You know, putting your ideas and your thoughts down on paper is one thing, but writing books and children's books especially has been something that you've been able to do. Tell me about how you came to be and what your line of books are about.
Yeah, so we got these affirmation books. We actually have four. I think I'm the only person that I've written more books than I've read. But but yeah, so we have these affirmation books for little boys and little girls. And it's an accompanying coloring book. And we just believe that how we talk to ourselves and how do we talk to our kids and what we feed our kids in terms of affirmations will give them a better opportunity to be successful in life. And if you read that to yourself and you say it to yourself, there's a good chance that it'll become part of your fiber. We think it was needed. We think it's something that's helpful for our elementary kids. And you see all the things that are taking place in our world. Obviously, to try and curtail some of that, we figured we'd write the book. It's not even about making money. Most of it is about it's about just giving back. It's about giving these kids something to hope for and to dream for, to let them know that they are important, that they are strong, that they are somebody. It's going over well. We'd love to get them there in the Birmingham area. Obviously, back in Montgomery, where I'm from, we got opportunity to do stuff there. But it was a fun project for us. And of course, it's like our mission. You know, we want to give back. It's one of the ways that we're giving back.
And where can people find your book?
Yeah, so all the books are on Amazon. If you go and put Reggie Barlow affirmation books, the ones for the girls and the coloring book, and then the ones for the young boys and the coloring book will come up. And we'd love to come and read or give out some there in the school system in Birmingham. So hopefully we'll have somebody reach out and get a chance to come up there, especially once our season is over.
All right. He is the head coach of the XFL's DC Defenders. It's Reggie Barlow. And we really appreciate it. I know you got a busy schedule and you guys are doing the hub thing all over the country right now, going here and there. But it's certainly a great opportunity for us to get a chance to talk to you. Good luck to you this weekend, Coach.
Right on. Always good to catch up. Thank you.